Hi, my name is Judy Marabito, and I have five Pomeranians. Kobe Bailey is the one who's sitting on my lap. This is Mr. Max and Sierra, and the one that you are holding is Rocky.
Judy Marabito isn't afraid to show off her animal side.
I think one of the things is that dogs really love you the way that you are, not for what you have in life, not how much money you have, or how you live, or who you are. They just love you for you. They're truly the only ones that love you unconditionally. And if I could get my husband to do that, that would be terrific.
Some of her animal children had disabilities, so Judy, who wanted to pamper her pooches, created some very special beds for her four-legged family members.
And I first started designing pet beds to make their life more comfortable, and I also wanted to have beds that went with the decor of the home, things that really didn't exist at that time, back in 1999. They had a lot of pet beds that we had tried, but they were never comfortable for my pets.
In her quest to comfort her friends, Judy says she realized she needed to pamper more than just the body. She had to soothe the savage soul.
Obviously, the designer pet beds and faux furs and all of those things are wonderful. And everyone needs comfort. But I realized that I think it was more than just about the comfort. It went much deeper than that. We needed to deal with the pet's emotional needs.
According to Judy, animals have very sensitive ears and hear more than twice what a human can.
So you can understand why much of the music that we listen to is not the soothing balm. It's actually the irritating instruments and tonal qualities that much of our music possesses that really agitate them. And that was over the course of many years that I had studied this, to see what works and what doesn't.
So Judy teamed up with this man, Grammy Award-winning music producer Tony Camillo, and says the pairing of her animal instincts and Tony's tonal talent resulted in a creation that is music to a dog's ears.
I don't believe that you really need to have the musical experience, I think. Tony Camillo has that. But as far as just knowing what pets love, I think just my passion that I have for animals and paying attention to their body language and truly knowing what they love, not what I love. I may listen to a piece and say, I love that, but do they love it? And I think we don't put anything together unless we know that the pets truly love it.
So is it relaxing? We conducted our own experiment.
If you listen to the lullaby that we have by Schubert and you listen to the way that it's done, we have it done in harp and, of course, some other instruments, but mainly done in harp, and it's very relaxing and tranquil for them. Why our music is so different than much of what we listen to today is because we deal with all the tonal qualities that are appropriate for pets, using specific instruments and sounds that do not trigger them to bark and are very calming for them. And that is, I think, really something that is the first of its kind to deal with pets' hearing.
Originally, the idea wasn't music to everyone's ears.
Tony Camillo, when he first heard this idea, I must tell you that he was a little beside himself with this one. I think he thought it was a little bit like a joke and not for real. But when he got to see how this music is, he got to know me, what I do, why I do it, and he also got to see the music and how the pets reacted to it. The pets that would come to his studio would actually start snoring during these special renditions that he was doing. And he said, wow, you know, I really think that she has something here. And he just thinks it's fabulous.
Since the release, Judy says the fur hasn't been flying, but the testimonials have been pouring in from all sorts of animals.
The first testimonial that we actually got in wasn't what you would expect. It was from a guinea pig named Dexter. Now, first I said, a guinea pig named Dexter. Come to find out, they also can hear up to 50,000 hertz like a dog as far as their hearing. And Dexter was not doing well. He stopped eating. They took him to the vets, everything. There wasn't anything the vet could do. Said, take him home. She got a hold of Doggie Classical. She put Doggie Classical on low volume next to Dexter's cage, played it over and over again. She stated that Dexter not only made a full recovery, started eating sing again, everything. And if she didn't play Doggie Classical for him, he just wasn't the same.
As an animal lover, Judy hopes she's helped create many happy endings for her listeners, and those success stories are what keep her going.
What I did was I did all the tests on my dogs, okay? Because the only difference between the dogs is sometimes you've got the Boston Terrier, which I sometimes call them the Boston Chewers. You have dogs that chew, dogs that dig, dogs that do different things, and you have different size breeds. But when it comes to their hearing, they're not all so different. So it's really not a surprise to me to find out that if it worked for my pets, that it's going to work for someone else's.